one.
Well, sir, you've been playing center.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, it's a pleasure to meet you. It's my honor, you know. Well, I'm glad that your wife invited me, you know, to, well, like I told her, I'm glad that I'm on her team because she's against drugs, and that's what I've been trying to do my own little way and doing what I feel, going back to the community and, you know, just trying to be a light at the end of the tunnel. A lot of us watching the kids who don't have home. So I'm really honored to meet you and your wife and be in the White House.
Well, I'm pleased to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you. See, I had so many things I wanted to say, and I see you can get all choked up on what to say.
I don't know that this will fit with the present work up there, but it's just a little belt buckle.
Thank you. I'm well honored and cherish it and put it with my, you know, other trophies that I have, you know. Yeah. Well, you're honored, you know.
Well, thank God. Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to see me and things like that.
Well, pleased to see you.
I think I was supposed to see some kids this afternoon, some of the diplomats' kids, and pass out some of my dolls, and, you know, I'm really glad to be here.
Well, that's great.
You got a rough job on your hand, and I know it's rough, but I can only say, like I told your wife and other people, she asked me, do I have any presents for the first family? That's all I have is love, because I know your job is rough. It's not easy. You know, you're gonna, some people are gonna like some of the things you say, some people ain't. You know, you can't please everybody, you know, so I can only say this, you know, you got to search your heart and do what you think is right, and the only thing I can say is just, God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you.
How have you been?
Señor Rigan.
Yes, do you remember him? Give it a abrazo.
Nice to see you. Yes, good
to see you.
After many years.
Sacramento.
When you first, for the first time you were governor.
You gave me your holster and belt, and I still have it hanging in my wrist.
And I got another one from my governor, but it wasn't finished on time, sir.
Oh.
And this was given to me in your name by Mrs. Sanderson. You remember Mrs. Sanderson, Dr.
Yes.
Mrs. Sanderson, she passed away.
Yes.
She gave me this in your name, and I still keep it.
Well, for heaven's sake.
Yes, so many years ago.
That.
I have the rubber band, this is a new one. Well,
here, and I know your family's going to come in, these are two flags, and indoor one and outdoor, two different types, both which are flown over the candle and the capital and the certificate. That, and
thank
because
you,
we were brought together by you, you got two flags.
Oh, you're terrific, amigo. Thank you very much. God love you.
Listen, I'm very happy to do it.
I'm honored to be with you, and I wish I could tell you many things. I was prepared, but we have a writer in Mexico. I said, when you are in front of the president, your legs start shaking.
So it shouldn't be.
So I'm honored, and I want to tell you that I will be coming with my lawyer and doing that for the past 16 years. And I go on TV, on radio, on newspapers, and we from California, Arizona, Colorado, New Mexico, Texas, Illinois, New York, Florida, and we I'll be very happy. We need, as we call it right now, a macho president, because of what you have done. We expect to keep on seeing you doing the things that we need for a man of your stature to do for the well-being of our America.
Thank you very much.
I mean it sincerely, sir. But President de la Madrid, I call and he says, greetings to you.
Very well. Oh, well, if you see him before I do, or turn on him. I think established a relationship that's good for both our countries.
I think we need that, sir.
Yes.
And don't believe whatever they say that Mexico's bad and against you. We have millions and millions of ambassadors that come here to illegal to work here in the United States, that they have a made a life, a social and economical life, a better way to live. So when they go there, although they might be illegals or legals, they speak wonderful United States.
Wow.
I have a son born in San Antonio. I have come here off and on for 50 years, living in the United States. And whatever I do, I will always remember your kindness, your country, your hospitality, your wonderful democracy.
Sir.
Thank you very much.
President, we need to get a picture,
yes.
Too.
Yes.
I get it. Thank you. Great. And one more. Thank you.
Down my tour, sir. 5 months tour.
Oh,
Oh, that's great.
And I'm at your disposal. You know, as your charming boy, I'd be very welcome. We see your pictures in Mexico, too.
I was up in New York today. I had to go up there to the Congressional Medal of Honor Winners Convention. And the young new president was born on December 7th, Pearl Harbor.
My goodness.
And his name is Ron. And his mother said that she named him Ronald because of a movie that I had made, a Western, but she said she couldn't remember the name of the picture or who I was in. Well, I had to figure. I only did one Western before Pearl Harbor Day. So I told him the name of the picture and that Lorraine Day was the leading lady and he could tell his mother.
What was the name of the picture?
Huh?
What was the name?
The Outlaw.
The Outlaw.
Yes.
Yes.
This is my wife. It's the first
time.
It's nice to see you.
Permita que le dé un abrazo.
Thank you.
This is my two sons.
Hello, nice to meet you.
This is the Texan. Mr. and Mrs. Borger.
Yes.
Hi, how are you?
Hello there.
Nice to meet you.
I think we have a picture taken with this family right here.
First, they will have
some of you.
All right. Why don't you flank us?
My brother is the tallest one.
That's fine. Great. Okay. Look this way. And one more. Thank you.
That was for real. What I used to say a lot of people in Hollywood, there was an old rule that if you were actors and you were at a party or something, someone taking a picture, you never would photograph with a drink in your hand. So that's why we as actors are really fond of each other. We're hiding our drinks
behind our heads. Porque cuando en Hollywood toman copas, escondían la copa detrás.
Yo le quiero decir que estoy muy emocionada por conocerlo, por lo que significa conocer al presidente del país más poderoso del mundo y por lo que lo ha admirado siempre como actor. Está muy emocionada.
She's very emotional because of what you represent. She's been a very great country because she used to see you when you were in movies and also because she's the most important man in the world.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Now, I think we should have a picture with the mayor and his wife.
Thank you. And one more, please. Thank you.
Presidential season here. We've got to finish
it. Shall I
don't have some pictures?
No, we don't.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay.
My son is studying in a school of 15,000 in a very exclusive university. I wish that my son could tell you the feelings of the young generation of Mexicans.
Well, sir, we're terrorists about the communism in the world and how is it it's trying to expand. And we're very, very happy about your determination and your character and how you have been handling all the things. There's a 15% of the university that it has very troubled mind that don't know what even they want. They don't even know what they want. And the rest of us are with you. And I'm very happy, sir.
Thank you. I'm very proud to hear that.
And not only that, sir, but the young universities of Mexico. I travel to Mexico 5 or 6 months out of the year. Then I spend 1 or 2 months making movies. And I go to different little towns, big cities. There's two cities that there might be a little bit of trouble. Mexico City, Guadalajara, Monterrey. But the rest of the cities, they are Catholic people, truly Catholic. And when the Pope came, even the president of Mexico had a mass in his home. So I gave Tom some of my thoughts that you might be reading later on. And that's the real thinking because I go to the people, with the people, with the down-to-earth people, bankers, officials, military, political politicians, and the feelings I wrote in my memorandum to you, which I hope you will get. that's the real thinking. And we wouldn't want to take your time, sir.
Oh, listen. And we'll see that you get these pictures.
Thank you. I hope we can get it on time because there is another nice suggestion, sir. I wanted to tell you this. The FCC knows how many hundreds and hundreds of radio, Mexican radio stations, Spanish radio stations there are in the United States. And also we have over 200 cities that cover Mexico City by satellite. to different parts of the United States. This is a tremendous thing that I have to suggest. In our own native language, for the father and mothers and homes of people that live in the United States, for the Mexican Americans, a little message of saying, my dear friends, President Ronald Reagan, wish you Merry Christmas, muchas, and God bless you. It would be a great thing to do. And if I may suggest,
but you can, I would have to say that in your language.
Feliz Navidad.
Huh?
Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
That just sounds easy.
You always say, my casa es su casa. Mi casa es su casa. You always say that.
I can say, muchas gracias.
Well, yeah. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Well, all right. I'll talk to our people about that. And right. and incidentally, what is the deadline on the pictures? I mean, when do you?
Well, I'm going back to Mexico Wednesday, sir, Wednesday morning.
Ooh.
And there's two men, we call the Walter Cronkites. I suppose I got a wire from Tom and from Mr. Bogart. I was going to go on TV. And this TV is watched by between 30 to 35 million people every morning from 7 to 11 in the morning. Every day and every night. That his name is Memo Ochoa. Very powerful man in TV, in Mexican TV, and in the United States. And in the evening, we call it 24 hours, Jacobo Zabludowski. That he goes very much into the homes because he plays between 9 and 10. And if you have, I already talked to them, and I canceled my appointments because Miss Sarah Long told me not to say anything, not to go on TV. So they say, you promise, and you come back. You tell us what you talked to Mr. Reagan about. I say, well, I'm just saying, go say hello. And I say, well, what about if I say, if he sends you a little note saying thank you for, thank you note? I said, oh my gosh, then you will have them on your side, and they mean a lot in the minds and opinions of the Mexican-American people, and the Mexican itself.
Well, now, wait a minute here. And you will say to them, Felicia Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
Beautiful. Oh, what a con job that was.
No,
oh, out of
never
nowhere.
Phrase until you just
beautiful.
Quick study.
Yes, you are.
thank you, sir.
Well, now, there's no, what is that?
His name is Memo Ochoa. He works in Televisa, which is.
And okay. You want a note from me to him?
Not from you to this man.
That you could deliver. Is that what you
mean? I can deliver. Yes. And to Jacobo Zabludowski, which they both are
two
very
one
important.
Or two.
One or two each.
One to each.
I mean, if you cannot do that later on, sir, tomorrow, the after, or next 15 days, whenever you have a chance. But that's.
This is the smallest part of your gift. The rest of it was taken from me at the airport. I had yours and Billy's present. And I had them specially made, and somebody's running around Washington with them. They're leather with your names on them. But this right here is just, this was just a little nothing. But I thought that you'd appreciate them and if you ever went out to look for them. So I thought you might want to have them for your collection.
Thank you very much. And I do have some, yes. Thank you. All right.
The great one was with it. They're in leather with your names on them, an engraved plaque on the inside in silver saying to the President of the United States and blah 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 and a ranchero and all that stuff has your name on it. And then on the tips, there's silver and gold tips on each side. You know,
you
like
somebody got away with those.
I turned around and I just turned for a second. And set this down. The girls, your secretary's gifts and everything else like that, and Clark's secretary, I had in my